Okay, so Xbox EXP.
They're gonna use Xbox EXP again, and the Freight Rain gonna be on the jungle side.
Kadira Moreno.
Okay. So this is it, ladies and gentlemen, the drafting phase for game number one. And with that, let's throw it over to our casters. Take it away.
Two teams, one with a promise to proclaim that they are the strongest yet again. The other with a promise to destroy the host
have been fantastic with all the control abilities that Bigatron Alpha has, and that's what AP Brand needs to watch out for. We saw this Xborg in action, it's really difficult to take down.
Yeah, and I think more so that it's got one of the few interactions that actually deal, oh wait, hold on, penalty zone actually coming out, so Rizzo goes with Last Insanity, breaks it open, Superken secures the turtle. Art Guard has already been used, but still, they have not been able to crack him open, and even the Kadidas, all has been stolen, and now with two low, three low, Moreno falls, they find a trade back, Superfin keeping them all topped up, with Kyle Teezy, the next to fall. It's a 3-for-1 trade in favor of Bigatron Alpha.
And this is a hot start for the robots. At this point, they look like Terminators because they're wearing black jerseys. And this is a purple buff going into the hands of BTR, but that's going to be hooked by Ogwin.
All right, so Super Genki gets pulled underneath.
Be aggressive, but Bigatron Alpha, they're getting it fast.
Yeah, they're doing it super quick. That true damage coming in from that export is helping that peel, but now the full combination from Moreno is going to take out Ogwin before they can even find that opportunity to get back in the fight.
The entries of Moreno have been great. One when he lands a hook, the other when he's going nom 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 on someone.
When he's
I think that's what he sounds like.
No, that's exactly it. It's accurate, but here comes the hard card coming in on towards Kyle TZ's side. Superkin, without it, he's gonna get locked down by the Bloody Hunt, instantly taken out by a few, and now Kyle TZ, he's gonna go even further, but he doesn't have the reset on the decimates because the kill was stolen away. Super Marco now taking the space to zone Sakin out. Bin will keep him topped up, but Moreno finds it on to Kyle. Oh, the mortar coils just in time with a sliver of health.
And
Major
the health
win.
Let's just try to get Sakin down, and they did. Bigatron Alpha and AP Brand meet up in the center of the map, poking out each other, just trying to find control.
Oh, nicely done. They push him right underneath the turret. He's low. Oh, that's the Appraiser's Wrath. That turns it around on Ogwin once again. Finished off by the Rough Wave. Superkin instantly invades that purple buff, looking for any trades back, but nobody has the damage to do so. Health is going to pull Superkin back in towards the team. The Heart Guard is being expanded. Breath of the Ocean is going to knock out for Sakin to finish him off. Oh, boy. This game is really going back and forth. Last Insanity doesn't take out Flap Teezy. Body of the Smith keeps him alive.
Man themselves. To the point where this is the case. The team that gave Onyx a lot of difficulty is now struggling to contest for this first Lord.
Yep, Cerezo, he's gonna lose his Viraga armor. Well, Last Insanity to work with. Moreno in the bushes, Sakin getting the free hits, and here comes the penalty zone. Hard Guard is put onto Sakin's side, keeping him alive, but the Blazing Duet is dealing way too much damage as Flap TZ is already down. Moreno makes an attempt, but the Bloody Hunt is all going to put on Superkin. Cerezo peeling them back, not allowing Few or Super Marco to close the distance. Sakin gets to run them down.
BTR are currently walking the walk. They've talked
a little bit more slower, a little bit methodical. Shout out to Randy Orton, I miss him. But look at them, they're playing like Vipers right now, just waiting for the perfect time to strike.
Yep, Moreno as well. He's keeping his eyes very open, talking to the Heart Guard already as we start peeling him. A Superkin is losing a lot of his HP, and now the Blazing Duet is out. Superkin is already down, and they cannot deal with Moreno getting a three-man rough wave. Cerezo comes in with the last Insanity, walking away with three kills for only one.
The counter-punching from Bigatron Alpha has just been way too much for AP Brent to handle. Only Flap and Few remain, and this Angela pick, this Super Vin, the highly touted roamer of BTR Alpha, it's not just him, it's everyone in BTR knowing the assignment and knowing when to enter.
They just keep on peeling AP Brent away one by one. The penalty zones are literally
two.
At least for Super Marco, he can actually challenge, at least challenge Sakin in that 1v1. But you know, it's never a 1v1. Now they're walking in with the help of the Lord. Moreno comes in to the backline. He finds Owen and he gets Sakin too. Kyle might have just turned this around single-handedly, but they're just rushing the base. It does not matter. Game number one concludes with BTR taking the game.
Moreno, the man who's been doing a lot of talking, is backing it up. What a pickoff by the Kadeta, and what a game by Bigatron Alpha.
Coach Aether na.
Bro, I'm on a roll this game. It's luck, it's luck, it's luck.
And let's see here what will happen in game two with this lineup from both teams.
Yeah, it's all going to back down on the early game. Who is going to be able to gain control? Will it be Bigatron or will it be AP Bren? Let's throw it over to the casters here for the second game of the series.
Thank you, Coach Aterna. I'm going to call back to a conversation I had.
He needs a hit level 4, so he's still a threat. And once he hits level 4, at least then it might be a deterrent. Cerezo sees 2, going to get locked down. Another air strike going to be committed on towards him as well. The sprint just not enough, especially when FlapTZ has that rage meter maxed out.
Yeah, okay. So Moreno has the ultimate here of the Lapu Lapu. Super Ken's close enough. I wonder if they're going to try and just trade things out here, see what else they can find. It's going to be 3 versus 2 in a bit. FlapTZ is going to go to the turtle.
I mean, they're posturing down on towards bottom side, but luckily, at least with Super Marco, he has to use his sprint to actually speed himself up. But here we go. Ogwen looking for the opportunity to try and block Cerezo so that Kyle can take it away. But no, Super Kenny still wins it out. Level 5, Iron Hook connects on towards FlapTZ's side. Oh, wait! He almost gets it. The Bloody Hunt is going to lock him down before Super Finn falls. The fuse, feathered air strike. It looked so good. The setup for someone like Super Ken to guarantee the neutral. And here comes Super Ken now getting punished. The feathered airstrike is good. FlapTZ helping to set that up. No way, Jose, are you going to invade us anymore?
Punished getting by his buffs. They're still posturing around the purple buff and around the jungle of AP Bren is BTR, but Slap gets hooked.
He gets hooked. Bloody Hunt. No opportunity to get out of there. Oh, poor FlapTZ.
And what a Meanwhile, it's actually going to be the warrior boots on the feet of Super Marco, still on the way to his first item, but it is very close. No considerable lead yet.
Kyle has to take the damage, and even the purple buff stolen away by Super Ken. At least these are one of the reads that Bigatron Alpha can get. 3 more seconds until the cooldown. No! Cerezo gets caught out. FlapTZ bothering to actually flicker for
it. Counter, here's Ogwen.
Yep, they find it, and now they're going to commit everything onto Super Finn, who has to flicker out and even uses the conceal. The counter engage coming in from Moreno. It seems good, but FlapTZ is able to power through. Bloody Hunt, damage reduction is good enough, but Fu can't take the damage. Moreno flickers forward and catches another. Ogwen, the last to survive. Kyle will find Moreno in the back line, too deep to be saved. Despite all the oppression and invades coming in from Super Ken, it's still, the level is pretty even, right? 11 to 11. Now this purple buff, once again, it's a very big red flag. BTR looking for an opportunity. Feathered airstrike to try and zone out the rest of Moreno already using. Gets the stun on towards 2. Rage Blade into the back. FlapTZ has to get on the way as the airlines has already been activated. The Bloody Hunt on towards Super Marco's side. The BMI is going to get him out just in time, but Saken, still healthy, still strong, but is able to deter the rest of them.
Somehow, AP Bren got to walk out of that with a kill. And no one going down on their side. That's the best they could hope for in that scenario. And FlapTZ getting out of range of Saken's crossbow of tank.
More, but here we go. Bigatron with a very clear lead. Super Ken is able to stop Ogren in his tracks. As Cerezo tries to take this 1v1 against KyleTZ. But in the meantime, Saken is able to break the mid tier 1. Clockwork, like you mentioned. Bigatron Alpha in Terminator mode.
Man, BTR, they're going to continue pressuring the jungle again of KyleTZ. Who's going to get this purple buff?
No, they locked down Super Ken, and now they're making sure that he doesn't have an opportunity for the airstrike as well as the Bloody Hunt on towards Super Marco's side. The BMI couldn't be activated. Cerezo's still alive, and KyleTZ ends up falling. No members of the bigger troopers fall. AP Bren wiped out.
And this looks dire. In a crucial game number 2, minions coming in, Lord marching on their side, close the 7 to 12 seconds on the timers. AP Bren were taken out of the map in a snap.
Super Vin landing a massive hook and catch onto Super Marco.
And he does it again. Moreno pushing Ogwin back. Feathered airstrike looking to punish. They find it as Super Marco will proxy the way with his and take his BMI away. They lose two inhibitors. They need to clear up these waves as much as they can. But Super Vin right now, he does not miss.
Yo, this could be the final moments here. This could be match point. Super Ken trying to zone off the rest of them as the last inhibitor begins to fall. Cerezo is just buying time, wasting Kyle Teezy's energy, forcing him to go back underneath the fountain. They need to look for the clear, but here comes the conceal. Moreno has the bravest fighter.
He finds it in the back line. Super Marco once again hits it. He's dead. And now we know damage. Cerezo takes out Flap Teezy, and Sokken is able to free hit. That's GG. Well played. Supervin left the kingdom because he sees the future with Bigatron.
Another massive hook. Another massive iron hook to cash out Super Marco. Supervin.
But seriously, with this kind of draft, they need to play very quickly on the early game. They need to secure the early game. If it drags to the late game, I think every brand draft have a stronger probability to win this game right now.
Why?
Because of the Cloud, because of the Varamis. It can sustain because on the late game, most of them gonna play on the team fight.
But Brody also can scale with a Weapon Master talent.
Water is immediately going to be fought for. Cerezo rotating early on with the changes to his jab, making sure that Arlott is a little late to the party, but here comes Flap Teezy, and now Few, he might be in a little trouble. First blood achieved instantaneously, and now the rest of BTR will start chasing them down in their jungle. Him alive down by bot time. Cerezo getting attacked by both Flap Teezy and as well as Kyle. He finds a kill back and will give the turtle to Bigatron Alpha.
Because of that sequence, yes, Bren got a kill, but Bigatron Alpha got another turtle. Constant pressure onto Super Marco. Ogwin now has to babysit him. They keep getting pushed back. AP Bren, Bigatron Alpha really just want to end this now. Really just want to make it to the grand finals. The Tower of the Quad.
Guaranteeing this lead. Purple buff stolen once again. Pop it on the swing. Wait, hold on. Ogwin, he might be in some trouble. He's gonna pull back Super Ken underneath the turret. Appraiser's Wrath as well. Moreno stealing away the call off and keep it alive. Misaken is able to break the tier 2. They're trying to run away. Super Ken finally getting punished as Flap Teezy with the final slash and Vengeance takes him out.
The clutch cult alters coming in from both teams. Uh-oh. Oh, so Rizzo finds Flap.
Alright. Alright, he gets the champion stance, but now he's gotta wait for at least 4 more seconds. Five more seconds.
Too much.
They start to back away. This mid-tier 1 is so important for Bren. They're getting invaded already, but without that tier 1, they're gonna lose absolutely everything. And now they jump in for the fight. Super Vin finds the wall time out to fight! Bad Bros! They go into the back line, and Sokken finishes them off! What a play coming out from Super Vin!
What a super set by the roamer of BTR!
Sokken and the people who question him. What's Sokken doing? Man, he is making sure that he's making sure his oppression is felt. Super Vin making a lot of damage, pumping on the string. He's gonna pull him back, but it's not gonna guarantee it. He almost call Ultra, saves Fuse life. Super Vin, wild charges, hits nothing, and now they're in the middle of the fight. The hard grind is not enough. Two is already down. Double kill for Sokken. You ask him, do you feel it? You gotta be sucking on these nuts. Bigatron Alpha, change that name. Bring it on, Alpha.
The Terminators are ruthless and relentless. They've built a lineup that can end this game.
Golden Staff by Super Marco and Flap Teezy with a Thunder Belt. I don't think that's going to be enough, but will AP Bren find a way? Hold on.
The final slash pulling Super Ken underneath the turn. The call. Altar is going to keep him alive for now, but they're waiting for the opportunity to turn this around. Appraiser's Wrath is going to put him low. Call Altar traded instead. Torn apart memories have already been used. He's out of position. Wild charge to put him out of his misery.
10 seconds for the Fire Mist to come back. That's going to be another. Maybe make it all of the base turrets of AP Bren going down, but they're holding on to the top one. They've held on to the mid, but the Lord is here. The Faramis is back. Full 5v4, Super Ken is down. Can Bigatron Alpha end it here?
They're holding on. Looks like Bigatron Alpha are waiting for the second Lord, as they usually do. this time around. Very, very patient.
Not even like remotely close to Sakin or Cerezo at all. He's literally almost doubling their damage in the numbers.
Now, this might be the end game here. Cerezo looking for opportunities. The Superkin zones around. Tier next inhibitor has already fallen as they continue to push on forward. There's not enough damage from the side of AP Bren as they're looking to chunk down this line. Superman finds two. Blazing Duet to try and clear out the wave, but it doesn't matter. Sakin Winds of Nature, he's trying to kill this out. GG! Well played! Bigatron Alpha are gonna make it to the grand finals!
The Terminators have delivered on their promise. They have swept RSGPH, Echo, and now AP Bren is Star Us.